Hello everyone. The title of this story is The Witch with an Itch by Helen Baugh, illustrated by Deborah, Allwright.
On the last day of witch school, the littlest witch passed her witchy exams with not one single hitch.
Hooray! She exclaimed as she started to run. At last, I am free for some mischief and fun.
The first thing she saw, looking slimy and cool, was a frog on a rock at the side of a pool.
Ho ho, thought the witch as she got into place, with a gleam in her eye and a grin on her face. I've learned all my magic. I know what to do. Now I will try out my first spell on you. Hubble and bubble and spittity spat. It's time for a change. Now turn into a hat.
But the witch got an itch as the last word was said and pointed her wand at a flower instead.
Something's gone wrong, said the witch to the cat. The frog hasn't changed, and where is the hat?
The next thing she saw as she went on her way was a spider spinning her web for the day.
Oh my, thought the witch as she got into place, with some doubt in her eye and a frown on her face. I've practiced for years. I should know what to do. Now I will try out my next spell on you. Hubble and bubble and flippity flume. It's time for a change. Now turn into a broom.
But the witch got an itch as the last word was said and pointed her wand at a toadstool instead.
No, cried the witch in a voice full of doom. The spider's still here, and where is the broom?
The next thing she saw, peering this way and that, was a newt in the shade, looking shiny and fat.
Oh, bats, thought the witch as she got into place, with the fire in her eye and a rage on her face. If this doesn't work, I won't know what to do. Now I will try out my last spell on you. Hubble and bubble and spittity spot. It's time for a change. Now turn into a pot.
But the witch got an itch as the last word was said and pointed her wand at a big stone instead.
The cat couldn't look and the witch lost the plot. The newt stayed the same, and where is the pot? That's it, screamed the witch, going red in the face, with no hint of calmness, composure, or grace. I've tried to be patient, but that's the last straw, and she threw her new wand down with force on the floor. It's not me going wrong, it's the wand. It's no good. It just doesn't work like a magic wand should.
Then, all of a sudden, the little witch spied a girl with a hat, pot and broom by her side. I believe these are yours, said the girl to the witch. And I think I know why you keep getting an itch. It's not the wand's fault, I'm afraid, that it's you. Would you like me to say what I think you should do? The witch thought about it, but not for too long.
Please tell me, she said, why are all my spells going wrong?
The girl cried. It's easy. Haven't you guessed? You're not a bad witch. You're one of the best. You're allergic to bad spells. You're good through and through. That's why only good spells will work out for you.
Only good spells, hissed the witch in a huff. Are you bad? Are you bonkers? I've heard enough.
Wait, begged the girl. Forget mischief and trouble. There's no need to bother with Hubble and Bubble. Please think of the spider, the frog, and the newt. I know they are not fluffy or cuddly or cute, but they have their own lives and like them a lot. So it's not fair to change them to things they are not. Just think up new spells that don't hurt anyone. Then your magic will work and your itch will be gone. The witch's mind started to whir and to whirl as she thought it over and then said to the girl,
"If you're right, then at last I will know what to do. So now I will try out my new spell on you. Hobble and bobble and tickety-tock, please turn that dress into a fancy new frock."
The spell worked like magic. The witch did not itch. The girl's frock was perfect, down to the last stitch. And from that moment onwards, they played every day, having fun with good spells.
And the itch went away. For more Read Aloud stories, keep watching Little Hearts Super Kids only on YouTube. If you like the story, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.